Praise the Lord.
Eyin Oluwalogo.
So I want you to take paper and pen and write your prayer request.
Mo wa fe ko mutakanda ati kalamu re ki o ko awon ebe adura re.
All those things you've been thinking about, you've been asking the Lord, this to happen, that to happen, is the time of fulfillment.
Gbogbo to tin saferi to n bere pe ko sele ninu aye re ni won sele.
If you don't have paper, write it on your hand.
Bo ba wari kalamu, e se to ko si atelewo re.
That is, today what you write and what you're asking the Lord is going to do it.
E tumo si pe loni ohun to bere to n ko sile yen a o se fun o.
I'm waiting for you to finish writing.
Mo n duro de ola ti kon to fe.
And when we finish the message and we're praying,
nigba ta ba pari iwasu ta ti gbadura,
you will raise up those prayer requests.
O na awon ebe adura won ni soke.
For yourself, for your family. If you are not married, you want a wife, congratulations today, today, today.
Ebe adura fun ara re, fun ebi re, waye o to ba ti se igbeyawo.
No husband yet. Praise the Lord. Today something will happen.
You
are married. There's no child. Praise the Lord. Today, that's where we're here.
O ti segbeyawo ko ti somo ayin oluwalogo idi re kan re tabi
wa blessing you're asking for.
Bo ba si se pe ibukun temi lo nfe.
You've been falling and rising. You want to be stable and steady.
O ti subu dide sugbon o fe ma rin dede bayi.
That's why we're here today.
Idi re ta fi wa ni loni.
Or you have been working for the Lord and there is no progress, there's no success.
Abi o ti sise fun oluwa be ni ko si aseyori ko si itesiwaju.
That's why we're here today.
Idi na re ta fi wa ni loni.
Anything that causes concern to you.
Not
only sickness, sickness, yes, God will heal you.
Ki ma se aisan nikan bi aisan wa nbe Oluwa yo mu olarada.
Have you written your request?
O wa ti ko ebe adura ti e.
All right, let's pray now.
E je ka gbadura wa yi.
Father, we thank you today.
Baba adupe lowo yin loni.
We bless your name for your church.
A fi ibukun fun oruko yin nitori ijo re.
We thank you, Lord, because you've called us together.
Adupe Oluwa tori pe e pe wa papo.
And you have called us to bless us.
E ti pe wa lati ibukun wa.
I pray that all your people, old and young, will experience your blessing today in Jesus' name.
Mo gbadura wipe awon eyan yin atomode atagba won ri ibukun yin gba lori loruko Jesus.
Let the joy go around.
E je ki ayo yen ko to kale.
Let the miracles go around.
Ki ise iyanu yin ko kari wa.
Let the victory go around.
Ki isegun na ko kari wa.
That everyone will know I got my own portion.
Ki eni kokan ko le wipe mo ri temi gba.
Lead us in your word right now.
E to wa ninu oro yin bayi.
And teach your people your truth.
Ki esi fi otito yin ko awon eyan yin.
We thank you because we know you have answered.
Adupe nitori pe amo pe ti dahun.
In Jesus name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
Thank you. We can be seated.
We're
looking at Malachi chapter 3.
And we Malachi ori iketa.
Reading from verse 16 to verse 18. Malachi chapter 3, verse 16.
Malachi ori iketa ese kerindini ogun.
Then they that feared the Lord spake one often to the other.
Nigba na ni awon ti o beru Oluwa n ba ara won soro.
And the Lord hearkened and heard it.
Oluwa si teti si o si ko.
And the book of remembrance was written before him for them.
Asiko iwe ranti kan niwaju re fun awon ti o beru.
Them that feared the Lord and that thought upon his name.
Fun awon ti o beru Oluwa ti won si nse asaro oruko re.
They shall be mine, says the Lord of hosts.
Won si je temi ni nikan ni Oluwa mo mumu.
In that day when I make up my jewels and I will spare them as a man spareth his own son that serveth him.
Le ojo na ti emi o da emi o si da won si gege bi eniyan ti ma da omo re si ti o si.
Then shall ye return and discern between the righteous and the wicked, between him that serveth God and him that serveth him not.
Nigba na ni eyin o yi pada e o si mo iyato laarin ododo ati eni buburu, laarin eni tin sin Olorun ati eni ti ko sin.
Today we're looking at a subject that many people never look at.
Loni a n wo koko oro to je pe opolopo ni isiju wo.
In our church here, Deeper Life Bible Church, we get saved, we serve the Lord.
Ninu ijo wa ninu ijo deeper life ni bi bi aba die ni igbala a o bere sisin Oluwa.
We many times were eager to become workers.
Lopolopo ogba anla kaka lati di osise.
In fact, we said a few months ago, maybe a few years ago, that if you have been in deeper life for about 2 to 3 years and you have been coming to the Bible study regularly, that you are old enough and qualified enough to be a worker, go to see your leaders and your pastors. They'll interview you. You ought to be workers.
Ni toto ni loloyi lakche filo wipe to batin wasinu ijo wato deni igbala fun bi odun meji tabi meta to se nkankan o ti ye o leto lati di osise to adari re lo ki won foro wo lenu o ko le di osise.
And if you are here today, you have been in the church for 2-3 years, you've been attending Bible study regularly, you know the word of God, you know you are born again, go and see those leaders. They'll interview you. There is work to do in the vineyard of the Lord.
Bi asiti wa ni loni bi o ba ti nigbala ti o ti pe odun meji ninu ijo yi to sin lo si eko bibeli deede sugbon to ti di osise to adari re lo ise wa fun wa lati se.
There are some of us that you might not have been called a worker, but you evangelize, you do soul winning, you preach the gospel, and while we're preparing for this program, you went all out bringing people, come, the Lord is going to do something. You're serving the Lord already.
Awon kan si wa laarin wa to je pe a fi orupo osise pe won, sugbon won sin Olorun, won wa sun rere, won pe awon eyan wa sinu ijo nigba ta ti e fe bere eto yi o darapo mo wa o jade lo o nsin Oluwa na.
You are in the church, you might not have any title. You say, I don't belong to this, I don't belong to this, but you are faithful in serving the Lord.
O wa ninu ijo ko si oruko ta nfi npe o gege bi osise, sugbon o nsise ni o nsise lo npelu otito o nsin Oluwa.
I want to look at the subject, the blessing of serving God. The blessing of serving God. Many people do not know the blessings they have and the blessings they ought to possess. God has his own kingdom. His kingdom is his government. In this world, we have kingdoms. The kingdom of the world is the government of the world. For example, in our state over here, we have the state government. If you are a worker with the government, you have salary. Once you are given your employment letter, and then your assignment is told, you are told, that's your assignment. You go for your assignment. At the end of the month, you expect your salary. Because you are a worker with the government. God has a government. He's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. His government is his kingdom. And when you are serving the Lord, he also pays salary. That's why we sing, it pays to serve Jesus. But many people do not understand when they sing, it pays to serve Jesus. I speak this from my heart. That's why how we sing it. But then when we come for our salary, we begin to do some funny things. I mean you as a servant of God, as a soul winner, as a worker, as a preacher of the gospel, we are like those workers in the government, in the state. When you work till the end of the month, and now you want to go for your salary, you don't beg the cashier because this is your right. In your letter of employment, it had been written that if you walk the way we're calling you and you're in the place we put you, we'll pay this and pay this and pay that.
Ati fi iwe igbanisise le olowo ati ko sibe pe to ba sise to si duro nibi ta fi o si eyi ni eto re.
At the end of the month, you don't go to cry before the cashier. You don't go to kneel before the cashier. You don't have to, you know, be promising this and that before that cashier will give you your salary. It is your right.
Ti osu ba ti pari o ni lo ma sunkun tabi dobale tabi kunle lati gba owo osu re eto re ni.
Not only that, as you continue year after year, your salary will not remain at the same level. It will be increasing year after year. For in many cases, in many governments, there is a regular annual increase, annual increment. Now, if you now do well and they promote you to another level, they increase your level, they change your title, they increase your salary.
Nigba miran bo ba wa to ba sise to won lori won a fun ni igbega won tun wa fun ni owo oya to tun leke nkan si.
Now after you get to another level,
leyin yi o tun wa de ipele miran,
they will not only give salary, they give allowance.
Ki se owo oya nikan ni won fun, won tun fun ni awon ajemonu.
This is your allowance.
Wani to ba ti segbeyawo ajemonu re re.
This is the medical benefit of the worker.
Eto ti itoju ti ilera ara re gege bi osise.
If you are sick,
bo ba saisan,
they tell you to go to the hospital.
Wani ko lo sile iwosan.
They are not going to charge you.
Won ni so pe ko sanwo.
If your wife is pregnant,
ki aya re ba wa nu oyun,
they say take your wife to the hospital.
Wani mu yawo re lo le iwosan.
They are not going to charge you.
Won ni gbowo lowo re.
If your children are going to school,
ba won mo re ba nlo le iwe,
this is the benefit of the school fees for your children.
Ile ni ajemonu ti owo le iwe fa won mo re.
And when you go to claim those things,
nigba to ba lo gba awon eto wonyi,
you don't cry.
O ni so,
you don't beg.
Oh, ni bebe.
You expect it to be given to you.
Ore ti pe ka fi ile olowo ni.
Because it was in your letter of employment.
Toro wa ninu iwe ta fi gba o sise.
Now, do you think that your state government is better and richer and more favorable than the government of God?
Iwo ajero wi pe agbani sise re lori ile aye pe o loro o tun jo looto ju Olorun orun lo.
If your state government will pay you what they wrote down in your letter of employment, don't you think that you don't have to go to God and be crying and be rolling on the ground and be praying and fasting before he gave you what he wrote on your letter of employment?
Ti awon o to gbo sise nile aye ba nfun ni eto re lai jija kadi lai sokun so o ma ro wi pe se lo e ko lo ma sun ko ma gbara yile ko to gbe to re lowo Olorun.
That's why today we want to look at the word of God. What God said he will do. Automatic. That is normal. You are a child of God. You are a worker. You are serving the Lord. You are not talking about idol. You are not talking about juju. You are talking about Jesus to your neighbors.
Oh, ma soro nipa awon orisa ile re tabi awon ogun sugbon o nkede Jesus ni gbogbo
gba. There is a blessing that is reaching down for you already.
Ebukun kan wa ta ti ko sile fun ona.
And today you will know your right.
Loni o si mo eto re.
And as you know your right, you go before the Lord.
Bi o ti wa mo eto re wa to Oluwa lo.
Lord, this is what you said.
Oluwa ohun to wire o.
You will do for me as a person serving you.
Pe o se fun mi gege bi eni to nsin o.
You will not cry.
O ni kibe.
You don't have to roll on the ground.
O nilo ati gbara yile.
You don't have to change your voice.
O nilo lati pa ohun re da.
You come normally.
O kan to Oluwa lo ta rara.
Every day blessing will be upon your life.
Lojojumo ibukun yo wa sori re.
Before I go to the text, as we continue serving the Lord, I told you for those of us who are working in the government, our benefits, remuneration, salary will be increasing. As we are longer and longer in the church, there are some people that say, when I became born again the first time, when I was a younger believer, believer,
God
used to answer my prayer. I pray like this, God will answer. I ask him like this, God will answer. But now after 5 years, 10 years, 15 years in the Lord, I'm serving the Lord now. I have this title in the church now. I'm a local pastor now. My wife is a local women leader in the church. My child is singing in the choir. But now, no more salary. Now there's no more blessing. Now there's no more answered prayer.
Oh,
you see that as you are growing up, you're going higher in the Lord. And then your benefits in the Lord, they are forgotten. The governments in the world don't do that.
They
higher we go in government service, the greater our benefits will become. Can you look at the people that serve the Lord in the Bible? They higher, they climbed in the service of the Lord. People like
Moses,
people like Joshua, people like
Caleb,
and people like David, people like
Daniel,
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego,
Paul the apostle,
and the rest of them, as they went higher and higher in the service of the Lord, their benefits and their blessings increased in the Lord. So if you say, I'm a worker, I'm a preacher, I'm a pastor, and no blessings today, all your rights will come back in Jesus' name.
The
blessing of serving the Lord. Number one, God's promise for all who serve him. God's promise for all who serve him.
You know,
some people say, I get, others say, I don't get.
Or
if you come back to the government again, that is our state government or local government, all workers have their benefits. They don't pay some and refuse to pay others. If God is greater, if God is more loving, if God is more faithful, if God is richer, He will pay all. He will answer the prayers of all. If you have that in your mind every time, I am a child of God, I am serving the Lord. If He is blessing A, He must bless B. If He is answering the prayer of C, He must answer the prayer of D. God's promise for all who serve Him. Number two, God's power while you serve him.
Agbara Olorun bi a tin sin.
God's power.
Agbara Olorun.
While you serve him.
Bi a tin sin.
Come back again.
E je ka tun pada.
Now, do you think that a state will have a governor without security and bodyguard around the governor?
Iwo ajero wi pe ipinle kan yo ni gomina ti o ni si awon eso to ro bayika.
Do you think that God will raise up a leader, a pastor, a worker, somebody is running errands for him, and he'll just leave him in the hands of evildoers?
Adari osise ton sin ni gbogbo igba ti o wa file ti o si aye re sile fun awon eni biburu.
I'm making the comparison between the government of God and the government of the world for you to understand that if God is more faithful than the people of the world, the same security, the same protection, the same power, the same cover, the same umbrella that the people of the world have, that their government is giving them, the government of heaven will give unto you.
mo nse afiwe laarin ijoba ti aye ati ijoba ti olorun to je wipe awon ijoba ti aye awon to nsin won won so won won da abubu won o wa so fun pe irufe abokan ipamo kan ati eto kan olorun orun yo fi fun o.
If you look at those who are highly placed in the world, they provide security for them. He is a director, he is a manager, he is a rector, he is a principal. He is, you know, as they go up like that, they provide security for them and for their families.
Njoma wipe awon to wa ninu aye ti won wa ni ipo giga bi giwa ile ise bi awon oga agba ni ile ise won fun won ni eto abo fun awon fun ara won ati ebi won.
The wife cannot just go out like that, and then there's no security, and they put people pushing here, her here and there, and her life is endangered. Even though it's the man that has the title, as they provide security for the man, they provide security for the wife and the children.
Iyawo iru awon eni to ga be lawujo le ise lohun ko ni kan jade bi en to nlo ti oni si abo. Bo ti eje wipe ohun ko ni oga ile ise sugbon eto oko re won o fi dabo bo fun ara re.
How do you think that God will only protect you and then he will expose your wife to the dark powers of the world? They will never touch your wife.
Bawo ni wo se wa ro wipe Olorun wa dabobo iwo yo wa fi aya re yo fi le awon eni aye lowo rara Olorun yo pa aya re mo.
And sometimes the workers, there are those who are serving the Lord, they'll be telling their children, if you don't buckle up and do this and that, the witches and wizards, they will catch you. Me, your father, I'm serving the Lord, and you, if you're not careful, witches will kill you. How do you tell your children that God will only protect you when you are serving the Lord? He'll not protect your children. He must protect your children.
Àwọn òṣìṣẹ́ kan wà tí wọ́n sọ pé èmi ń sin lọ́n tèmi ẹ̀yin ọmọ ẹ̀jẹ̀ múra kẹ́ ẹ túnra dì dáadáa kí èṣù mọ̀ bá fi mú yín gbolẹ̀. Báwo ni wọ́n ṣe jẹ́ rò wípé Ọlọ́run ò pa ìwọ tó ń sin mọ́ yóò wá fi àwọn ọmọ rẹ sílẹ̀ Olúwa yóò pa ẹbí rẹ mọ́.
God's power while you serve him.
Agbára Ọlọ́run bí a ti ń sìn.
Number 3.
Ìkẹta.
God's plan for those who serve him.
Ètò Ọlọ́run fún àwọn tí wọ́n ń sìn.
You know the governments of this world.
O mọ àwọn ìjọba nú ayé yìí.
That's why they have records of their workers.
Abájọ tí wọ́n ní àkọsílẹ̀ àwọn òṣìṣẹ́ wọn.
As you come into the employment.
Bí a ti wá gbaṣẹ́ lọ́wọ́ wọn.
You have somebody ahead of you.
O lẹ́nu nǹkan tó tún ga jù ọ
lọ. He has somebody ahead of
you. O náà tún lẹ́nu tó ga jù lọ.
And they are making records about your work.
Wọ́n sì ń ṣe àkọsílẹ̀ iṣẹ́ tó ń ṣe.
And when there is any opening for promotion,
nígbà tí àyè bá ṣí sílẹ̀ fún ìgbéga,
before they advertise it to the outsiders,
kí wọn ó tó kéde sáyé gbọ́,
they bring the people who are inside and they push you forward.
Àwọn tí wọ́n bẹ nínú ilé wọ́n tì wọ́n sókè.
On the basis of the records they have written concerning you, they say it's fit for that post.
Nítorí àkọsílẹ̀ iṣẹ́ tó ti ṣe tí wọ́n ní wọ́n ní eléyìí yẹ fún mi.
There is a plan.
Ètò wa
for everyone that is serving the Lord.
Fún ẹnì kọ̀ọ̀kan tó sin Olúwa.
Plan for those who serve him.
Ètò Ọlọ́run fún àwọn tí wọ́n sìn.
God has a plan for you today.
Ọlọ́run ní ètò fún ọ lónìí o.
I congratulate you that you are here.
Mo bá ọyọ̀ pé o wà ní.
You will never be the same again.
O ní wà bákan náà mọ́.
Always have it in your mind.
Gbogbo ìgbà ni kó nínú ọkàn rẹ.
I am a child of God in the family of God.
Pé ọmọ Ọlọ́run ni mí nínú ẹbí Ọlọ́run.
I am a servant, I am a worker in the kingdom, in the government of God.
Ìránṣẹ́ ni mí, òṣìṣẹ́ ni mí nínú ìjọba ti Ọlọ́run.
And there are blessings for the sons of God that serve him.
Àwọn ìbùkún sì wà fáwọn ọmọ Ọlọ́run tí wọ́n sìn.
Number 1.
Àkọ́kọ́.
God's promise for all who serve him.
Ìlérí Ọlọ́run fún gbogbo àwọn tí wọ́n sìn.
Exodus chapter 23.
Exodus orí ìkẹtàlélógún.
I'm reading from verse 25.
Wọ́n kà láti ẹsẹ̀ karùndínlọ́gbọ̀n.
Exodus 23 verse 25.
Exodus orí ìkẹtàlélógún ẹsẹ̀ karùndínlọ́gbọ̀n.
And you shall serve the Lord your God.
Ẹ̀yin ó sì máa sin Olúwa Ọlọ́run yín.
And you shall serve the Lord your God.
Ẹ̀yin ó sì máa sin Olúwa Ọlọ́run yín.
And he shall bless thy bread and thy water, and I will take sickness away from the midst of thee.
Òun ó sì bù sí oúnjẹ rẹ àti omi rẹ, èmi ó sì mú àrùn kúrò láàrin rẹ.
I want you to look at this as your employment letter from the government of God.
Mo fẹ́ kó wo ẹsẹ̀ yìí gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìwé ìgbanisíṣẹ́ t'Ọlọ́run fi gbà ọ síṣẹ́.
You are giving now the letter of employment.
A ti fi ìwé ìgbanisíṣẹ́ lé ọ lọ́wọ́ báyìí.
You are released to go on serve.
A ti wá yọ̀ǹda rẹ láti lọ máa ṣiṣẹ́ ẹ̀sìn.
A soul winner, you are released to go on and serve.
A
singer, you're released to go and serve. Usher, security, released to go and serve.
Fellowship
leader, you're serving.
Adari
leaders, you're serving.
Adari obirin,
campus, school, children, workers, you're serving.
Our
pastors and preachers, you're serving. Soul winners, those who go about, you give tracts to people, you telephone people, you tell them, serve the Lord, come to the Lord, you're inviting people to the church, you're serving.
You're cleaner,
you're cleaning the church for the church to be neat and appropriate for worship, you're serving the Lord.
The Lord
has given you the employment letter, and you shall serve the Lord. Here is the salary. Here is the benefit. Here is the remuneration. Here is the pay. The Lord will bless your bread and bless your water. He will take sickness away from the midst of thee. You don't have to cry for this one. You don't have to beg for this one. Serve the Lord, this will follow. Serve the Lord, this will be given to you. And then he says, I will take sickness from the midst, from inside of you. What does that mean? Your kidney is inside you. It'll take sickness away from your kidney. Your lungs and all your intestine, everything inside you, today, not only today, every day of your life, it'll take sickness away from the midst of you. Verse 26. There shall nothing cast their young nor be barren in thy land. You will not have miscarriage. And you will not be barren. All that barrenness is cancelled in Jesus' name.
And
sometimes you say, I didn't see sister so-and-so in the church. I didn't see brother so-and-so. And then one day they came. Brother, sister, I didn't see you in church this time, that time. It's true. I'm trying to take care of myself. What did you do? There is a mountain somewhere. They say, if somebody stays in that mountain and he sleeps on that mountain under the dew, under the rain, under the sunshine, and he doesn't sleep on mattress, he sleeps on the ground there of that mountain, 7 days, children will come.
You
are in the government of God. You have your letter of employment, and he said part of that condition and the benefit of your employment is that you will not be barren. You have to go and sleep on the mountain for God to be faithful to do what he said he will do. From today, no mountain anywhere. In verse 26, and the number of thy days I will fulfill. Who am I talking about? You will not die young. I said you will not die young. He said the number of your days I will fulfill. A little headache, a little something there, and then he says, I'm dying, I'm dying. Who is dying? You will not die. You are still 43, you are still 61. You say you are dying. If you die, who will do the work over here? There's work for you to do here.
o se se pe odun 43 abi odun 111 wa lo nku lo to ba ku ta ni osise ise wa fun o lati se.
This work you will do it until you get old.
Ise yo a o se titi ta fi dogbo ni.
Until Jesus comes, the number of your days he will fulfill in Jesus' name.
Titi digba ti Jesu yo fi de ojo re ni yo kun ni oruko Jesu.
Deuteronomy chapter 11.
Deuteronomy ori
kokala. I'm reading from verse 13.
Wo kala ti ese iketala.
Deuteronomy chapter 11 verse 13.
Deuteronomy ori kokala ese iketala.
And it shall come to pass if ye shall hearken diligently unto my commandments which I command you this day to love the Lord your God and to serve him with all your heart and with all your soul.
Yo si se bi eyin ba feti si ofin mi daradara ti mo fi lele ni ase fun yin ni oni lati ma fe oluwa olorun yin ati lati ma sin pelu aya yin gbogbo ati pelu okan yin gbogbo.
Then it rides many benefits and the promises of your service there.
O wa ko awon akosile ileri ati awon ibukun to je eto
rebe. Verse 21. Wo
ese kokanleni ogun.
That your days may be multiplied and the days of your children in the land which the Lord thy God, which the Lord swear unto your fathers to give them as the days of heaven upon the earth.
Ki ojo yin ki o le ma po si ati ojo awon omo yin ni ile na ti Oluwa bura fun awon baba yin lati fi fun won bi ojo orun lori ile aye.
The promise of the Lord for you as you are serving the Lord.
Ileri Oluwa fun obo tin sin.
The days of heaven on earth.
Bi ojo orun lori ile aye.
Is there a mental problem in heaven?
Se wahala wa lorun ni?
Mental insanity, brain problem in heaven.
Arun opolo nbe lorun bi.
Should you have mental problem?
So why ki wo ni arun opolo?
I can't hear you.
Emi o gbo yin o.
The life of heaven on earth.
Igbe aye orun lori ile aye.
Cancer in heaven?
Se jejere wa lorun.
Should you have cancer?
So why ki wo ni jejere?
Incurable disease in heaven.
Arun ko gbogun so wa lorun.
Should you have incurable disease?
So ye ki wo larun ti o gbogun.
Today you are healed.
Loni amu olarada.
As you are healed, God will keep you healthy in Jesus' name.
Bi ati mu olarada Oluwa ni o pa omo ni ilera ni oruko Jesu.
Job chapter 36.
Job ori 36.
Job chapter 36.
Job ori 36.
Some people say I am Job.
Awon kan so pe to oro mi emi kan re o Job ni o.
Me, I am not Job, I am William.
Emi ta wo yi o mun ise Job William loruko mi.
I said so you are mention your own name.
Emi ise Job Joseph loko temi.
Aha, Joseph is a good name now.
O ko re na ni Joseph o.
Praise the Lord.
Eyin Oluwa logo.
What is your name?
O ko re tin je.
Some people, I am Job, I am Job. Thank God I am, look at me here. I am not Job o.
Awon kan so pe emi te wo yo Job re o Job. Emi temi a wo mi re dada. Joseph ni mi.
In the book of Job.
Ninu iwe Job papa.
It is very clear when you are serving the Lord.
O kan gbagba pe bo ba nsin Oluwa.
Look at chapter 36.
E wo ori 36.
We read in verse 11.
Ese ikokanla la otika.
Chapter 36 verse 11.
Ori 36 ese ikokanla.
If they obey and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasure.
Bi won ba gbagbo ti won si sin won lu ojo won ninu irora ati odun won ninu afẹ.
Did he say you will serve the Lord, you obey the Lord, and then you will have poverty and pain?
Se un to so ni wipe to ba sin Oluwa pelu ara re pelu okan re wipe o wa ni ose ati ise.
Look up here. There are some people that have the idea.
Egboju soke awon kan wa to ni ero ilokan.
They say deeper life is for holiness.
Won ni ijo deeper life iwa mimo la won.
Then they say this other church is for prosperity.
Ijo oke ohun a si ki la won leki.
What they think is that where there is holiness there's no prosperity. Where there is prosperity there is no holiness.
Ero ti won ni wipe nibi ti iwa mimo ba wa ko si a si ki. Ibi ti a si ki ba si wa a gbodo menu ba iwa mimo.
And if you tell a deeper life member who does not understand the fullness of the word of God, and you say, God will prosper you, they will not say amen. If you say, God will give you prosperity, they will not say amen. When you say, God will make you holy and sanctified, amen and amen and amen.
Àwọn ọmọ ìjọ wa kan wá wà ó tó jẹ́ wípé wọn ò ní òye ẹ̀kúnrẹ́rẹ́ ìwé mímọ́ tó bá gbàdúrà pé Olúwa yóò fún ọ ní àsìkí ó kan rí sínú àmọ́ nígbà tí ó bá tó pé Olúwa yóò mú ọ ṣeré wọn ni àmì tó bá wá sọ pé Olúwa yóò fún ọ ní ìwà mímọ́ àmì wọn yóò lu òrùlélé.
He says, you will obey the Lord and serve the Lord. That's holiness. If you are holy, you are obedient to the Lord. Holiness does not drive away prosperity and peace and pleasure and health and blessing. Holiness is the foundation of prosperity. Holiness is the foundation of having peace of mind and having prosperity and having progress in life. Look at that verse 11 again. If they obey and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasure. Today, this blessing will come upon your head.
Bi won ba gbagbo ti won si sin won lu ojo won ninu irora ati odun won ninu afẹ eyi o wa suri re loni.
The promise for all who serve him.
Ilere Olorun fun gbogbo awon ti o sin.
Acts of the Apostles chapter 27.
Ise awon apostle ori iketa.
I'm reading from verse 23.
Won ka ni ese iketa le ni ogun.
Acts chapter 27 verse 23.
Ise ori iketa di logun ese iketa le logun.
For there stood by me this night the angel of God, whose I am and whom I serve.
Nitori angeli Olorun ti eni ti emi se ati eni ti emi nsin o duro ti mi ni oru ana.
Because I serve him, look at what he said, saying, fear not, Paul, thou must be brought before Caesar, and lo, God has given thee all that sail with thee.
Nitori pe ohun sin gbo n to wi o wi pe ma beru Paul. Iwo ko le sai ma duro niwaju Kesari siwo Olorun ti fi gbogbo awon ti o ba owo popo fun o.
The Lord, they were on the sea, on the stormy sea.
Won wa ni oju agba mi nibi ti jinja.
They were afraid they will all die.
Be ni won beru pe gbogbo awon ni oku.
They were afraid there will be accident on the sea, on the stormy sea.
Iberu wa lokan won pe wahala yo wa lori agba mi oku
mi ti jinja. And that everybody will die.
Pe gbogbo en ti benu oko ni oku.
God said, Paul, because you are serving me,
Lord, why pe Paul nitori pe ohun sin mi,
I want to preserve your life.
Mo fe paye re mo.
It is part of my promise for those who serve me.
Ara ileri mi ni fun awon ti won sin mi.
Not only that, all these people that are with you in the ship, because of you, they will not lose their lives. Accident will not kill them.
Eyi nikan ko nitori wipe ohun sin mi gbogbo awon ti won wa nu oko pelu re nitori ti e po ohun sin mi won pa won mo ijamba oni kan won.
They were about 176 people.
Won de die ni orin le nigba.
Paul, only one righteous man.
Paul enikan soso to je olododo.
275 other people.
Awon eniyan ti won din die ni orin le nigba.
Because of this righteous man serving the Lord.
Nitori enikan soso olododo yi tin sin Oluwa.
He said, because of him alone, I will preserve your life. All the other 275 will enjoy the benefit and protection of you serving me.
Oluwa wa pe Paul nitori ti enikan soso to je olododo to nsin mi gbogbo awon orin ni nigba awon eniyan won yi to nsin mi won pa won mo.
Why don't you think?
Eseto waru.
You are serving the Lord.
Onsin Oluwa.
You have family members up to 5 or maybe 10.
Oni molebi ti won to marun tabi mewa.
God said, because of one Paul, I'll preserve Paul and the 275.
Olorun wa so pe tori Paul kan soso to nsin mi won pa awon eyan to le nigba
yi mo. Because of you, only one person in your family born again, serving the Lord, all the 5 people, all the 10 people in your family, they will not die prematurely.
nitori iwo to nsin oluwa to de atunbi to nsin olorun nitori iwo nikan soso gbogbo eni tin benu ebi re won o ni kula ipe ojo.
These are the promises of the Lord. The promises of God are yes and amen in your life today. Point number two, God's power while you're serving. God's power while you serving. In 1 Kings chapter 13. 1 Kings chapter 13. If you read it from verse 1, you will see how the man served the Lord. But there was a king there. His name was Jeroboam.
Jeroboam,
Jeroboam was an idol worshiper. And this man that God sent from Bethlehem Judah, he was declaring the word of God against the idol. Jeroboam, the idol worshiper, did not like that. Chapter 13, 1 Kings verse 4. And it came to pass when King Jeroboam heard the saying of the man of God, which he had cried against the altar in Bethel, and he put forth his hand from the altar, saying, lay hold on him. Lay hold on him. Maybe you are working in a village. A pastor in a village. Pastor's wife in the village. Or you are one of the regular faithful members evangelizing in that village. When you say, come and contribute money for idol worship, say, no, I'm born again. Or when they say they want to build a particular shrine, come and do your part. No, I'm born again. They say about this other church. They are born again too. They say about Shimon, the pastor of that other church. He pays his own due. He is born again too.
They say, I don't know about
they are being born again, but me, I'm born again the Bible way.
The minimum money.
And when you are born again the Bible way, you will not serve idols. Am I talking about you? I said you will not serve idols. And so there is a Jeroboam in that place. And he said, leave him, I will deal with him. Leave him, God will deal with Jeroboam. I said your God will deal with Jeroboam. So he said, lay hold on him. Look at that verse 4. And his hand which he put forth against him dried up, so that he could not pull it in again to him.
Has
God changed? No.
He
still protects his own. There is still power in heaven and on earth to protect all the people that are serving the Lord. From today, the protection of the Lord will be secured in your life in Jesus' name. 2 Kings chapter 6. The story here is that the king of Syria was fighting against Israel. And there was a servant of the Lord in Israel. His name is
Elisha.
And every time the king of Syria planned against Israel, Elisha will reveal the secret to the king of Israel. So the king of Syria began to wonder, who is telling the secrets we discuss here to the other king so we cannot defeat him?
Oh,
and they said, there's a man serving God over there. His name is Elisha. So he said, go and catch him, capture him and bring him, I'll deal with him. No idol power will be able to deal with you.
ko si agbara orisa kan ti o le dojuko.
No power of darkness will conquer your life or conquer your family or conquer your church in Jesus name. Second Kings chapter 6 verse 13. And he said, go and spy where he is, that I may send and fetch him. And it was told him, saying, behold, he is in Dothan.
Oun si wi pe e lo iwo ibi ti o npe wa ki emi ki o le ranse lo mu wa asi so fun pe wo o wa ni Dothan.
Therefore sent he thither horses and chariots and a great host, and they came by night and they compassed the city about. And when the servant of the man of God was risen early and gone forth, behold, an host compassed the city both with horses and chariots, and the servant said unto my lord, my master, how shall we do?
Ni ese ke dogun nigba ti iranse eniyan Olorun na si dide ni kutukutu ti o si jade lo wo ogun yi ilu na ka ati esin ati keke iranse re si wi fun pe ye baba mi awo ti se.
And he said, he answered, fear not, for they that be with us are more than they that be with them.
Ohun si dan wi pe maberu nitori awon ti o wa pelu wa ju awon ti o wa pelu won lo.
That power is still there today.
Agbara yen si wa be loni.
Look up here for a moment.
E poju soke bayi na.
Do you know that angels don't die?
Nje mo wi pe angeli ki ku.
How many of you know that angels don't die?
Eyin me o le mo pe awon angeli ki ku.
But we think and we act as if angels are dead.
Sugbon se la nro asi ma ngbe igbese bi pe awon angeli ti ku.
The angel that went to Sodom and Gomorrah and took out Lot and his family, they have not died, they're still alive.
Awon angeli ti won lo si Sodom ti won fa Lot ati aya re jade won si wa laye won oko.
The angel that went in between the children of Israel and the people of Egypt when they went through the Red Sea, they are not dead yet, still alive.
Awon angeli ti won lo ti won duro laarin awon ara Egypt ati omo Israel nigba ti won la okun pa koja won oku won be laye.
These chariots, these angels that protected Elisha and the servant, they don't die. They have not died, they're still alive.
Awon angeli to da bo bo Elisha ati iranse re won ma si wa laye won o ti ku.
You say, why don't we see them?
E se ta wa ri won.
Just like the servant of Elisha did not see them.
Gege bi iranse Elisha eniyan Olorun o se ri awon angeli won yi.
They are there.
Sugbon won wa nbe.
That's why the New Testament says when we come to church that our sister should cover their head because of the, tell me, angels. They have not died, they're still there.
Idi re ni yo ti ma je mu ti tun fi so fun wa pe nigba ti awon obirin ba wa sinu ijo lati josin ki won bori won nitori kini e so fun mi o. Nitori awon angeli.
As you go back to the village,
bi e tin pada lo si abule.
As you go back to your local government,
bi e tin pada si joba ibile yin.
They that be with you are more than they that be with them.
Àwọn tí wọ́n wà pẹ̀lú yín ju àwọn tí ń bẹ pẹ̀lú wọn lọ.
Look at verse 17.
Ẹ wẹsẹ̀ kẹtàdínní ogún.
And Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes that he may see. And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw. And behold, the mountain was full of chariots and of horses and chariots round about Elisha.
Elisha si gbadura o si wi pe Oluwa emi pe o la ni oju ki o le riran. Oluwa si la oju odomokunrin na o si riran si wo oke na kun fun esin ati keke na ye Elisha ka.
Your life is protected.
Aye re wa labe abo Olorun.
The number of your days he will fulfill.
Iye ojo re loluwa yokun.
You know, there are some people that say, when I was, you know, in the major city, I used to evangelize. When I was, you know, over there, I used to evangelize. But now I come to the village here, I'll be very, very careful. Because the village is different from the city. In the city, you can go about dismal tracks, knock on doors, and do this and that. I'm not in the village. I don't want them to kill me. Who is killing you? Nobody can kill you. I said nobody will kill you. As you have been faithful in the city, if you are not in the village, go on and preach the gospel. Your life is preserved in Jesus' name.
Àwọn kan wà tó jẹ́ pé wọ́n ti wà ní ìlú ńlá nígbà kan rí tí wọ́n sin Olúwa níbẹ̀. ise wa gbe won wa si abule won ni won mo te jeje ni o tori wi pe awon ara abule ile o tori won o pa mi ta ni o pa o ko se ni ti o pa ma si oluwa nso ni oruko jesu.
Daniel prayed.
Daniel igbadura.
And then the people that were persecuting didn't like his prayer.
Awon eniyan to je pe won se nu ni bi ni si won o feran adura tin gba.
But Daniel said, whether you like it or not, I will serve God, I will pray.
Amo Daniel ni pe be fe be ko won o sin oluwa won o si mo gbadura
nbi. So they threw him in the lion's den.
Be ni won ju sinu okini hun.
And then the king rose up in the morning.
Be ni oba wa di ni kutukutu
lo. He cried with a lamentable voice.
O ke pe pelu orere ekun.
Daniel.
Danieli,
servant of the Most High God,
is
your God whom you serve day and night.
Olorun re ti won sin to san toru.
Is he able to protect you?
O wa le da bubu.
Daniel replied, you will reply.
Daniel ifohun lati nu ho iwo no fo jade
forever.
Oni oba ko pe.
God has sent his angel and has shut the lion's mouth.
Olorun ti ran awon angeli re o si ti pa awon kini lenu mo.
Is the power and the protection of God for everyone serving him.
Agbara ati abo Olorun wa fun gbogbo awon ti won sin.
He will deliver you from every evil work.
Yo gba o kuro ninu ise buburu gbogbo.
2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 18.
Timothy keji ori keji ese keji ni
2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 18.
Timothy keji ori ke
the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work.
Ori kerin ese keji ni ogun Oluwa yo yo mi kuro ninu ise buburu
gbogbo. And will preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom.
Yo si gba mi de inu ijoba re orun.
To whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.
Eni ti ogo wa fun laye ati lai lai.
Now that's what the Lord will do.
Ohun to Oluwa yo sere.
I want to show you one verse of scripture.
Mo fe fi ese iwe mo kan han.
You need to mark it down right there.
O ye ko sami si gan
ni. 2 Corinthians chapter 1.
Corinthians keji ori kini.
Verse 10.
Ni ese ikewa.
For the people who are saying, yes, pastor, what you are saying, I used to experience that.
Fun awon ti won so pe Oluwa mo ni iriri eyi.
I was like that. When I was a new convert, the Lord healed me. The Lord delivered
me.
And many times he made me to overcome all those things that had to come against my life. This verse tells us what he did in the past for you. He will do today for you. He will do in the future for you. The word delivered has three parts.
Oro ti a pe ni gbigba niyan o wa pin si pa meta.
Past tense, he delivered.
Ni tele o ti gba ni nigba kan
ri. Present tense, he delivers. He delivers.
Lowo lowo bayi o n gba ni.
In the future he will deliver.
Ni ojo waju yo tun ma gba ni.
Past, present and future, the protection of the Lord will be upon your life.
Nigba kan ri ni isisiyi ati ni ojo ola abo Oluwa yo wa lori re.
2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 10.
Corinthians keji ori kini ese ikewa.
Who delivered, past tense, who delivered us from so great a death?
Eni ti o ti gba wa nigba kan ri ni eni ti o ti gba wa kuro ninu iku ti o tobi to be.
Look at the next part. And does deliver, that's present tense.
Gbogbo lohun to tele ti o si un gba wa lowo lowo bayi.
Look at the next part. In whom we trust that he will yet in the future deliver us.
Gbogbo lohun to tun tele eni ti awa gbeke wa le pe yo si ma gba wa.
You find that word deliver three times in that verse.
Ori oro pe yo gba wa ile meta ototo ninu ese yi.
In the past he delivered.
Nigba kan o n gba wa.
In the present he does deliver.
Lowo lowo bayi o n gba wa.
In the future he will deliver.
Lojo waju yo tun gba ni.
If Jesus tarries.
Bi Jesu ba fa bibo re seyin.
And then we are coming back again together.
Ta tun lanfani ati pada wa lekan si.
Your seat will not be vacant.
Ijoko re oni sofo.
Your place will not be empty.
Ipo re oni sofo.
As you are here today, you'll be here again.
Bi o ti wa ni ilo ni o tun wa ni lekan
si. The next time I see you, you'll be stronger.
Nigba tin ba tun ri o lokun si.
You'll be healthier.
O tun lera si.
And you'll be more prosperous.
Be lo ti tesiwaju si.
And the blessings of God would have multiplied in your life.
Ebuku Olorun yo si ti po re koja nu aye
re. He delivers today, he will keep on delivering you.
O ti gba ni, o n gba ni lowo lowo bayi yo si ma gba o.
Number 1,
Akoko.
God's promise for all who serve him.
Ileri Olorun fun awon ti won sin.
Number 2.
Ikeji.
God's power while you serve him.
Agbara Olorun bi o tin sin.
Number 3.
Iketa.
God's plan for those who serve him.
Eto Olorun fun awon ti won sin.
God has a plan for you.
Olorun ma ni eto fun o.
Don't compare yourself with every Dick and Harry in the world.
Mo fi ra re we ta ja te ran ta Olorun.
You're not a Dick, you're not a Harry.
O yi se eyan yeye.
You are a special person serving the Lord.
Eyan to ni o tin sin Oluwa.
And God has a special plan for you.
Olorun si ni eto pataki fun o.
That plan he will fulfill.
Yo si mu eto na se.
Your expectation will not be cut short.
Ireti re la ni.
I was waiting for your amen there. Jeremiah. Chapter 29. I'm reading from verse 11. Jeremiah. Chapter 29. Reading from verse 11. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil. To give you an expected end. Your expectation will come.
Ireti re yo wa o.
Your expectation must come.
Ireti re gbodo de.
Even though it has tarried until this time, this time is a time of fulfillment for you.
Bi o ti e ti fa se ti di akoko yi.
What did you think that God brought all of us together at this time?
Ki lo ro pe Oluwa ko wa se ni na.
We have not done it like this before.
Ah ti se bayi ri.
Don't you know it's because of you?
Show my point to read here.
Don't you know he had you in mind? He knew what you were going through. And he said, I know the plan I have for you. I know the thoughts I have for you. Then it says, then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray, and I will hearken unto you. And ye shall seek me and find me, where ye shall search for me with all your heart. The time has come for him to wipe away your tears. And all those things you've gone through and you said, will this ever happen? Will this ever happen? Your time has come, it will happen. Sometimes ignorance brings discouragement. And ignorance brings a wrong action. Sometimes you are walking in a place. You've been there for years. And then you'll be wondering, why am I here? I'm not promoted. I'm not moving forward. The people that came after me, they are climbing over me and they're going
forward.
And then you said, I'm fed up here. Even if I don't have any job, I'm not going to stay here again. Meanwhile, you are thinking like that, the management of that place of work, they are having a meeting. And the people who know your faithfulness, they are talking about you. They're saying, Mr. So and so have been working in this place all these years. It should be at this scale, at this level now. And so they all agreed in that place. And they said, all right, next month or whatever, his promotion will come. And to be fair to him, we're going to give him triple, because he should have got it this year. This year we had everything together, we're giving it at this time now. Ignorance brings discouragement. Ignorance brings a wrong action. Since you are ignorant of the meeting they are holding, you are ignorant of the decision they have taken, you write a letter of resignation.
Enough
is enough. If I don't have job, I know I don't have job. I will not face this ridicule in this place anymore. After writing the letter of resignation, luckily for you, you didn't just drop it with a secretary. Because the secretary was not in that meeting. You went to your boss.
You said,
my boss, I want to thank you. You have been nice to me. But the system has not favored me.
I decided,
I don't want to go without telling you. I'm reaching this letter. I'm dropping my letter of resignation. And your boss said, you don't know the meeting I'm just coming out of now. In that meeting, we have decided that you have been cheated. We're going to be fair to you now. Your promotion is on the way. He says, take your letter of resignation. Go and tear it. Be waiting for your right letter. Your letter is coming. And so if you have been discouraged,
I've
been serving the Lord. Look at this one. Look at this one. Look at this one. Ignorance brings discouragement. Tear your letter of resignation. You will not backslide. You will not run away from God. Your letter is coming.
Letter your rainbow.
I said your letter is coming.
Money, where are your rainbow?
Have you written your request?
So where be adura re?
What is it?
Onda.
Where?
Onda.
Why don't you stand up?
Eche to di deduro.
It's coming.
Ombo.
I said it's coming.
Ombo.
I said it's coming.
Ombo.
You are going to have it in Jesus' name.
Wariti egba ni oruko Jesu.
Open your mouth and talk to the Lord. Thank the Lord because he's going to repay all the people that are serving him. He's going to answer the prayer of all his servants. He's going to fulfill the promises he has made to you. He knows your life. You are significant in his sight. He will do you good. He will answer your prayer. He will destroy the works of the devil. Healing, he will heal you. Deliverance, he'll deliver you. Miracle, he'll work out your miracle. Promotion, he'll give you the promotion. He will preserve your life. You will not die in this condition. He will give you your right. He will fulfill his promise in your life. Tell the Lord. He blesses the people that serve him. He blesses the people that serve him. The time of blessing has now come. Your time of blessing has now come. In Jesus' name we pray. Raise up those papers. Father, in the name of Jesus,
Baba,
I thank you for every brother and every sister. Those who are inside and those who are outside. In the youth hall, in the children's hall. In the campus hall, everywhere. As they raise up their prayer requests. Oh Lord, every detail of those requests fulfill for them in Jesus' name.
Oluwa gbogbo ti be ninu iwe ebe adura ye se fun won ni oruko Jesu.
Wipe all their tears away.
Enu omi je won nu gbogbo.
Take all their sorrows away.
Emu ibanu je won kuro.
All that discouragement in their hearts, cancel it in Jesus' name.
E fagile gbogbo irewesi tin be lokan won ni oruko Jesu.
They have waited until this time.
Won ti duro titi di akoko yi.
And they keep on serving you until this time.
Be ni won te won sin titi di akoko
yi. Nobody here will serve you in vain.
O se ni ti o sin lasa tin be ni.
The blessing of service will be upon all your children in Jesus' name.
Ibuku ise esin yo wa sori gbogbo awon mo yin ni oruko Jesu.
Those who are sick, heal them.
Awon ti won se ese mu won larada.
Those who are oppressed, set them free. Those who have been facing difficult times in their localities, oh Lord, I pray, turn everything around for the better in Jesus' name.
awon ti won la igba ti o derun koja ninu aye won oluwa mo gbadura e mu ki o gbogbo ko rorun fun won ni oruko Jesu.
Destroy all the works of the devil.
E pa gbogbo ise isoro.
Cancel every hindrance before them.
E fagile gbogbo idena ti be lona won.
They will go up.
Won goke lo.
They will climb up.
Won goke lo.
They will soar up like an eagle.
Won goke lo bi eye idi.
And nothing will stop their progress in Jesus' name.
Ko si so ti o dena ire won ni oruko Jesu.
Every good thing they are reaching down on those papers. For those who don't have any paper, they know it in their heart. Lord, this is what I want. I pray that this day will be the day of fulfillment and performance.
Orere gbogbo ti won ti ko sinu iwe won ya ta won ti o ko sugbon ti won ni lokan won Oluwa mo gbadura e mu ibukun won se nu aye won loruko Jesu.
Give everyone the fullness of joy.
E fun eni kokan won ni ekunrere ayo.
And when we see one another,
baba si tun pada rira wa,
we see your blessing upon everyone.
Ari ibukun yin laye eni kokan won.
Confirm it in every life, Lord.
E fide mu lenu aye wa.
In Jesus name we pray.
Loruko Jesu ni agbadura.